It is a beautiful day here in Miami. It's about 55 degrees and sunny. If I had a boat, I'd be out there right now, fishing the edge, the kite up, bait down deep, looking for that sailfish, wahoo, kingfish, tuna. It's gotta be a good bite today. But in this video, guys, I wanna announce the new boat. We're finally going into the mold, which means we're about 2 to 3 months out. And I wanna tell you a little bit about it, why I chose it, and what I look for when buying a boat. I've been coming down here to Hollover. I've been checking out all the boats going out of the marina while I have my morning coffee, get ready for my day. And there's just been some absolutely incredible boats going out of the inlet each day here, between, you know, 25 CVs with single motors all the way up to 39s with quad motors. I want to show it to you guys. I've been getting up the drone. Check out some of this footage. Here we go. Alright guys, so you got to see pretty much what's going out of here in Miami. Some pretty awesome boats out there, from small center consoles to big cat boats. You guys saw that Invincible with quads on it. I couldn't even keep up with the drone. And honestly, most of the boats, I can't keep up. The drone does about 45 miles an hour, but a lot of these boats are 0 to 70 in no time and just out of there. So maybe one day I'll invest in a faster drone, but that's pretty cool you guys got to see it. But for me, there's three things that I look for when buying a boat that I have to have. And while I was at the Fort Lauderdale Boat Show recently, I walked around the boats and kind of showed you guys a little bit about what I look for. Number one, I always look for three-piece construction. I gotta have that toe kick room, whether I'm releasing a fish, whether I'm fighting a fish, or if I just have people on board, kids or anglers that are not experienced, it's a lot better and safer to have three-piece construction. It also makes installing rod holders a lot easier, installing undergunnel lights a lot easier. There's just a lot of benefits. Apparently it's a stronger construction as well when you have a three-piece boat. So that's the first thing I always look for.
What is three-piece construction? Three-piece construction is when you put a top cap onto the hull and you form that bond with the deck and liner, right? So you can see here, three-piece construction. The main advantage is gonna be the toe kick space right here, right? So you can see here, my thighs are up against the padding and plenty of toe room right here. So what that means is if I'm fighting a really big fish up here, swordfish, you know, sailfish or whatever, you feel way more secure in the boat versus a two-piece hull when you kinda, you know, you just don't have that toe room. And you know, it's just, a lot of people say it kind of feels like a bathtub, right? You're just kind of in the deck and liner, but there's no cap on it. When you got this cap, you can also put lights underneath here. You can install more rod holders a lot easier. But the main thing is really safety, fishability. And you can see here, this boat just has plenty of toe kick area all the way to the bow. Right here, when you lean over, I mean, you're in the boat. You're securely in the boat. So that's number one.
Number two, I always look for a flat deck from the bow of the boat to the stern of the boat. I gotta have a deck that's flat. When I'm running around there like a madman, whether I'm hot on a fish, I can't have steps or seats in my way. It drives me crazy. I gotta be able to run from the stern of the boat all the way up to the bow when a rod is going off in the bow, and I have to be conscious of stepping over anything or worrying about my anglers slipping and falling or having to fight fish over a seat. Now, there are compromises in boats. There are forward seating that are, you know, less depth on them, so you can actually fight fish over the forward seating. But for me, I just can't have it. I'm not ready in my fishing career yet to have forward seating. That's something, if you guys have a family, if you have small kids, or if you're just doing a lot of cruising as well as fishing, that's a good compromise for you. Looks like an old Aqua Sport coming out here. A lot of jet skis going out here today. So the third thing I look for is a deep V boat. I like a boat that has a deep V because it's going to ride a lot better going out to the grounds, especially in any kind of chop. I like a 24, 25 degree dead rise. That's the V in the transom. When you come off a wave and you come down, it's a really soft bounce. You don't bang yourself. Typically, you know, a lot of boats in the past that I've been on have rather flat backs, usually 12 degrees or so. So when you hit a wave, you know, you really slap, but you're able to get a little bit shallower. You know, boats that have less V usually drift a little better, a little bit more stable. You know, my boat that I chose here is not going to be the most stable boat there is, but it's going to ride really well, and it's really what I look for. So without further ado, I want to tell you guys which boat I chose here. Here we go. I chose the 25 Latitude made in Fort Myers. Just a quick little brief on the 25 Latitude. It is the old 25 CV Don McGee hull. When I heard that they were rebuilding this, I had to see him in person. For me, it's like seeing an old Porsche 993 being rebuilt by Porsche over here. Just an old classic coming back to life. I had to have it. And when I saw the changes that they made to the boat, such as raising the deck, moving the console forward, adding a third bait well, I knew it was the right boat for me. And while I wanted a bigger boat, I really wanted to put a 29 CV on this channel. I wanted it for myself, of course. It's just a little too big, too much money, and I give up a little bit too much as far as chasing baits in shallow, as far as, you know, working the flats for bait, working, you know, the bridges for tarpon and stuff, a little bit too big. The 25 Latitude that we're talking about, I can put a trolling motor on it, I can still go in pretty shallow and, you know, that 16, 18 inch range, and I don't give up the tarpon fishing, the snook fishing on the bridges. I'm just not ready to give that up yet. I still love it too much. And ideally, Captain Mike needs two boats to really do it all. So the 25 Latitude is a perfect hybrid for me. I'm gonna be able to continue to do it all for you guys. We're gonna be even doing some sword fishing. We got Captain Matt coming on here in a little bit. He wants to get out and do some sword fishing with me. So I just think it's the perfect boat. And as the boat goes through the build process, I'm gonna bring you guys with me to the factory and show you everything I'm including. I'm trying to build this very simplistic, less is more, no frills type boat. I don't want to put too much money in it, too much stuff that I won't use. I want it just a hardcore live bait boat that we can go out there and crush the fish. So that's the boat, guys. I'm going to leave you here with some more boats going out of Hollover just to show you guys what everybody else is using. You'll see some 25 CVs going out there. Every time I see one, I just drool. So I'm so excited to have one. I'm so excited to introduce it to you. So please be sure to subscribe to the channel if you want to see more about the boat build. I'm going to bring you guys along with me. It's going to be exciting. We'll be back on the water here in the spring. So that's the boat, guys. We've been really busy. I started a tackle company. Let me grab this. This is one of my first orders that I'm shipping out here. If you want more information about this, just go to livebait.com. I'll be talking about it a little bit as we move forward. but I've been working really hard on this, so I'm excited to bring you guys really high performance products as well as use for myself. Now I know I got the good stuff. I'm also writing another book. For those of you guys that don't know, I love to write. It's a hobby of mine. I've turned it into a little bit of a more of a business. If you guys want to know more about what I write, you can go to charterfishingbusiness.com. I wrote a book on how to become a fishing guide. My new book, I'm really excited to publish. I'll tell you guys more about that in a future video. And we got the Miami Boat Show coming up. I'll be over there. I'll give you guys the exact dates, but we usually go the first day and then one day over the weekend. I just got a lot of stuff going on. It's nonstop. We're creating content. We're gonna get some more stuff out. I appreciate you guys for coming along with this journey with me. And we're just gonna have some fun out there. Tight lines, I'm Captain Mike with RealPorts.com. A lot of people think I've been really like sad because I haven't had a boat, but honestly, it's been really good for me. I've been able to get so much done. I started a tackle company. I'm writing a new book. I'm gonna be writing a second book soon. I've been able to, you know, do things with the family that I haven't been able to do. So not having a boat is actually good for a captain every now and then, but it's wearing on me, and I can't wait to have one. I can't wait to share it with everybody. Today's one of those beautiful days where I would just put on an old pair of Champion sweatpants and a sweatshirt and have a coffee in my hand, go out there, catch bait early in the morning, bring out some friends, bring out you guys with us, and just have a blast catching fish. These are the days that you really remember, because we don't get these really cold days here in Miami, so they kind of get cemented in my brain. I remember them all like they're yesterday, especially when we have good days out there catching fish. Guys, I want to thank Chef Valerie. Today is her birthday. I made her hold the camera for us. Chef Valerie, cumpleaños feliz.
Gracias. Bye.